Thank you. I invite you to join me in the spirit of prayer before we begin this ceremony and before speeches are spoken, degrees conferred, and tassels turned. I want you to savor this moment. I want you to look around, graduates, at all of the people who are with you, who are here for you. I want you to look at this lush green campus, and I'm not going to say anything about the skies for right now. I am going to say, and I wrote this a while ago, not understanding what the weather was going to be like, that I want you to soak in this moment. So will you join me in prayer and a moment of gratitude? Holy One, by all the names we know you, God, Hashem, Allah, truth, wisdom, we are grateful for the gift of commencement and for everyone and everything that makes this celebration possible. Open our hearts and minds and hands to fully appreciate this gift and every moment of our fragile and magnificent lives. Be with us as we savor and celebrate the gift of learning, the Hood College community, and especially these graduates. Amen.
Good morning. My name is Tanya Fenton. I am a proud Hood alum, class of 1978, and I now have the privilege to serve as the chair of the Board of Trustees. On behalf of the board, it is my honor and pleasure to welcome you to today's commencement ceremony and the conclusion of the 131st academic year. An impressive milestone for a small liberal arts institution that got its start as a female seminary. This graduation ceremony marks the achievements of you, our graduates, and the beginning of a new purposeful life and a thrilling phase of your lives. It underscores the support and selflessness of your families, the talent, hard work, and accomplishments of our faculty who have guided you on your journey, and the diligence and care of our staff and administration who work tirelessly to support the college and its students. Congratulations to you all. You do us proud. You graduates leave a Hood College that is stronger for your loyalty and for the time that you have spent here learning, growing, and preparing to live worthy and fulfilling lives informed by what you have experienced here. We hope that you will share your pride in Hood with others, and please stay in touch. Before I turn the podium over to President Chapdelaine, I want to take a moment to recognize this as her last commencement. Andrea, as an alum, I am grateful for all that you have done for my alma mater. And as a board member and now board chair, I am awed by your leadership and your guidance through challenges and triumphs. You will be so missed. It is my pleasure now to introduce Hood College President Andrea Chapdelaine, our smart, energetic, inspiring, and capable leader.
Good morning. Yay for the weather! Everybody, just keep that good karma going. We gather today to celebrate the 274 undergraduates and 221 graduate students who are the class of 2024. Yay! I would like to begin by acknowledging the many who have joined us today. First, our public dignitaries, thank you for being here and for all your support of Hood. Welcome to the college's Board of Trustees, who shared their time, talent, and treasure with Hood so generously. Trustees, please stand to be recognized. I also wish to thank members of our Board of Associates and Alumni Executive Board, alumni, and other friends of the college for being here today. Graduates, the attainment of your degree is attributable in part to the Hood community. The faculty and staff have provided both the push and the support needed to ensure your progress and well-being. Please join me in a round of applause to show your appreciation. And last, but certainly not least, welcome to our guests, family, coworkers, mentors, and friends. Graduates, you know these folks are your village. Let's hear your thanks. And now to the stars of today's show, class of 2024. Do you remember this? Pop Up or Flat Andrea, she's come to be known. For many of you, this is how I took your Welcome to Hood picture. So I thought it would kind of be fun to take us back for a moment. I am so glad that for many of you who graduated from high school and others from college during COVID, that we are able to give you your first live, in-person, up-close, beautiful weather commencement ceremony. So about you, you amazing class. 38 of you receiving a graduate degree today also earned an undergraduate degree from Hood. 6 of you are not only Hood students, but also Hood employees. 12 of you are active duty military or veterans, and 4 of you were just made into commissioned officers. We thank you for your service. 28 of you are relatives of Hood alumni, some multi-generation Hood alumni here today. You hail from 21 countries in 18 different states. During your time at Hood, you discovered and pursued your interests and passions with excellence. You helped ensure the vibrancy of our community, whether in the classroom, the learning commons, commuter lounge, graduate school, office, theater, on the playing field, and yes, even on Zoom. Your leadership and service has made an impact on campus, in the Frederick community, and across our world. Thank you. Thank you for your contributions, and bravo. Commencement is always a bittersweet day. The sweet, of course, is the joy and the pride. The bitter is that today you say goodbye to Hood and venture out beyond our beloved campus. Humanity has been hit hard during your time here. You have. Our individual and collective well-being has been negatively impacted by the pandemic, social media, political tensions, global conflict and violence, and alarming environmental events. I have witnessed, I have worried over the challenges, the anxiety, the fragility, the fear, the divisiveness. Yet, despite all those challenges, I have witnessed your resiliency, your strength, your drive, passion, and most important, the kindness and support you have shown to each other. These attributes will propel and sustain you through all the great adventures awaiting you. You also take two other important possessions. Number one, an exceptional education that has provided the knowledge and critical skills for professional success and personal growth. You indeed are armed for a fulfilling and meaningful life. Second, as Hood alumni, your Hood family will be with you every step of the way to give support and guidance. Never hesitate to reach out and do stay engaged. In closing, although today is all about you, I am claiming presidential privilege to talk about me for just a moment to offer a bit of advice. As you know, I also will walk across this stage for the last time today, and as I have shared, leaving Hood was an incredibly difficult decision, one that Dave and I made to be closer to our families. And that brings me to the advice part. When facing hard choices, always choose love, whether love of self, others, country, the world. Decisions based in love, even when scary and hard, will always be the right ones. And that love itself will strengthen you through that challenge. This job has been one of life's greatest blessings. I have loved being your president. Thank you for the joy, lessons, and inspiration you have given me. And although I know you will not find me here, you can find me. You know how LinkedIn works. I will always be ready to help or simply just to be glad to hear from you. Thank you. It is now my distinct honor and privilege to pay tribute to a retiring faculty member. Flat Andrea can probably go now. Thank you, Jewel. Catherine Orloff joined Hood College in 2006. As a professor of journalism and film studies, she brings an eclectic background in journalism and the movies to the college. She developed the film studies minor, has served on many committees, and presented at conferences. Professor Orloff has been a wonderful mentor and teacher to her students and an amazing member of our faculty. On behalf of the Board of Trustees, I am honored to grant Professor Orloff with Professor Emerita status. I now have the pleasure of introducing our two student speakers. First, Gabby Guiza. Today she earns her master's degree in environmental biology, her second degree from Hood, having earned a degree in biomedical science in 2022. Gabby has been the president of the Graduate Student Association for the past 2 years and has made a positive impact on our community by fostering a welcoming and inclusive environment for all students. She was nominated and chosen by our faculty to be today's commencement speaker. Noah Turner is the class president and today earns his bachelor's degree in political science. Earlier this week, he earned a commission as a second lieutenant in the United States Army, joining their ordnance branch as a bomb technician. Noah was a resident assistant and earned the Lachlan Award for his contributions to the Hood community. Upon leaving Hood, Noah will train in Virginia and Florida before being stationed in South Korea. Welcome, Gabby.
Thank you, President Chapp, for the lovely introduction. I am honored to have been chosen to present all graduate students today. Good morning and welcome to all graduates, STEAM faculty, family, and friends. Today marks a significant milestone in our lives. And as we gather to celebrate graduation, I would like to highlight how truly exceptional you all are. Pursuing graduate education while juggling other responsibilities, such as full-time jobs and raising a family, sometimes even from a distance, as it is for our international students, can be hard and take a toll on us. We have all faced hardships and moments of uncertainty during our graduate journey. It is important to recognize that we are all human, but please remember how capable and strong you truly are. Your dedication, perseverance, tenacity, and intelligence have brought you here today. This is truly an admirable accomplishment, and you should all be beyond proud of yourselves. Hood College has taught us critical skills that will help us succeed in life. I would like to thank all the professors and the staff for helping us become who we are today. Their dedication and commitment to our growth went above and beyond. I want to give special thanks to April Bolton, Dr. Ferrier, and Catherine Gottlieb for guiding me with wisdom and unwavering support. I would also like to thank my family. None of this would have been possible without their support, especially my parents. Dad, your belief in me and your continued support for my career path have been the foundation of my success. Mami y papi, gracias for all your love, hard work, and example. You have inspired me to be the best version of myself, and to always strive to help those around me so we can build a better future together. I am incredibly fortunate to have served as the Graduate Student Association president. This role allowed me to witness firsthand the caring, diverse, and accepting nature of Hood College. As we celebrate our achievements, let's hold close the core values of Hood: hope, opportunity, obligation, and democracy. I embrace these values during my time here, and I will uphold them throughout my life to contribute to making the world a better place. To my fellow graduates, I leave you with this. Never forget the journey that brought you here. Let the challenges and triumphs you've experienced at Hood College guide you as you embark onto your next chapter. Be bold, be compassionate, and most importantly, stay true to yourselves. Congratulations, grads.
Thank you, Gabby. Ladies and gentlemen, esteemed faculty, proud parents, and most importantly, the incredible graduating class of 2024. Today, as we stand on the precipice of a new chapter, we're not merely celebrating the culmination of our 4 years of hard work and our dedication. No, today we're commemorating something far more profound. We're celebrating resilience, perseverance, and the unwavering spirit that has carried us through the most unprecedented time. When we embarked on this journey 4 years ago, none of us could have predicted the challenges that lay ahead. Yet here we are, triumphant in the face of adversity. We've weathered the storm of a global pandemic, navigated through uncertainty with courage and determination. We've adopted to virtual classrooms, mastered the art of Zoom meetings, and found creative ways to stay connected despite physical distance. We supported each other through moments of doubt, lifted each other's up when the weight of the world felt heavy on our shoulders, and emerged stronger, more resilient, and more than united than ever. Each of us has a story to tell, a testament to our individual and collective strength. We've overcome obstacles, embraced challenges, and emerged victorious. As we step into the world, let us remember the resilience we've culminated at Hood. Let us embrace challenges with open arms, knowing that we have the fortitude to overcome whatever obstacles may come our way. Let us never forget the power of community, the strength and solidarity and the beauty of resilience. So to the graduating class of 2024, I say this: celebrate this momentous achievement, for you have no doubt earned it. But also remember the journey that brought you here. Remember the challenges you've overcome, the lessons you've learned, and the bonds you've forged along the way. Congratulations, class of 2024. The world awaits, and I have no doubt that each and every one of you will continue to shine brightly, illuminating the path before you with your resilience and your courage and your unwavering spirit. Thank you, and may the future be as bright as your dreams.
Thank you, Gabby and Noah. And now, on behalf of the Board of Trustees, I would like to honor President Andrea Chapdelaine for her 9 years of incredible service to Hood College, our students, faculty and staff, and the Frederick community. Andrea Chapdelaine, as a first-generation college student, you embody the notion that education is an essential part of achieving the American dream. Thanks to your visionary leadership, you have strengthened the college and enriched the Hood community through the implementation of 2 strategic plans. Your impact on the college has been nothing short of transformative. Therefore, be it resolved, for your accessible and transparent leadership, your dedication to students, faculty, and staff, and your forward-thinking strategies that have positioned Hood as a premier institution of higher education in the region, the Board of Trustees of Hood College hereby confers upon Andrea E. Chapdelaine the Doctor of Humane Letters, honoris causa, with all the rights, honors, and privileges appertaining thereto, given under the seal of Hood College, Frederick, Maryland, on this, the 18th day of May in 2024. I now invite President Chapdelaine to the podium to receive her diploma.
That was a little surprise. Thank you, thank you, thank you. For the graduates who are getting wet, if you didn't grab a poncho when you were lining up, I asked the ushers who are back there to bring them up. So you should start seeing people walking with ponchos. If they aren't coming, please come so that we can get you guys covered. We have two other honorary degrees to award. First, Dr. Christine L. McHenry from the Hood class of 1973. The citation reads, in part, Dr. McHenry, your generosity toward Hood College has had a profound impact on our campus. You followed in the footsteps of your mother, Gloria Schmidt McHenry, class of 1942. After graduating from Hood, you earned your medical degree from the University of Pittsburgh and began a long career in pediatrics. As a woman in medicine, you were a pioneer. Your vested interest in human rights and dignity led you to earn a master's degree in theological studies from the United Theological Seminary in Dayton, Ohio. During this time, you remained a steadfast champion of your alma mater and served on the Board of Trustees from 1997 to 2005. Given your unique background, you understood firsthand the important role that spiritual life plays on a close-knit campus like Hood's. In 2008, you endowed the McHenry Dean of the Chapel as a tribute to your parents, Gloria and Tom. Since then, this position, ably led right now by Rev Beth, has touched the lives of countless students, faculty, and staff. This vital role is part of what makes Hood a spiritually and intellectually diverse environment. Therefore, be it resolved, for your lifetime of service in the fields of pediatric medicine and healthcare education, your commitment to the well-being of patients and their families, and your unwavering support of your alma mater's spiritual prosperity, the Board of Trustees of Hood College hereby confirms upon Christine L. McHenry, the Doctor of Humane Letters, honoris causa, with all the rights, honors, and privileges appertaining thereto, given under the seal of Hood College, Frederick, Maryland, on this, the 18th day of May, 2024. I now invite Christine McHenry to the podium to receive her diploma and the marshals to assist with the hooding. Okay, I see ponchos coming, so raise your hand if you want one. Ponchos down, but they're good, they're good. It is now my pleasure to introduce our next honorary degree recipient and our commencement speaker. Senator Cardin, your citation reads in part, you have diligently represented the people of Maryland for more than 50 years. A proud third-generation Marylander, you began your career in politics the same year you graduated first in your class from the University of Maryland School of Law, becoming a member of the Maryland House of Delegates in 1967. You served as a delegate for 20 years. As Speaker of the House, you led reforms of educational funding and ethical standards for elected officials. In 1987, you became a member of the U.S. House of Representatives. You were instrumental in authoring bills to increase support in education for foster children, incorporate preventive screenings as part of Medicare, and strengthen retirement plans for American workers. As a U.S. Senator, you championed environmental causes, protecting the Chesapeake Bay, sponsoring resolutions to combat climate change, and finding ways to reduce pollution and ensure that every American has access to clean air and water. You have fought to guarantee equitable access to quality education, backing legislation to fund student aid, thank you, teaching training programs, mental health support for students, literacy and art initiatives, early childhood education, and student debt relief. Sounds good, doesn't it, graduates? You have been an exceptional friend to Hood, securing funding through the 2023 omnibus appropriation bills to help us prepare our students for professional workforce. As a proponent of higher education, you understand well that investing in our students is an investment in the future of this great state. Therefore, be it resolved for your dedication to the state of Maryland and its citizens, your efforts to better the lives of Americans, and your contribution to environmental protection, health care, fiscal reform, education, and civil rights, the Board of Trustees of Hood College hereby confers upon Benjamin L. Carden, the Doctor of Laws, honoris causa, with all the rights, honors, and privileges appertaining thereto, given under the seal of Hood College, Frederick, Maryland, on this, the 18th of May, 2024. I now invite Senator Carden to the podium to receive his diploma and the marshals to assist with the hooding.
President Chapdeline, thank you for the kind introduction and for inviting me to address the graduates. But it's a particular honor to receive this honorary degree from Hood College because of what Hood College means to our community and nation, and because of your extraordinary leadership during this period of time. Congratulations for a job so well done for so many years. We appreciate it very, very much. Dr. McHenry, it's also great to receive the award with you. You have a distinguished career also, so I'm in really good company. And Gabby, your comments were right on, so you're a hard act to follow. So thank you very much for your kind comments. And to Class President Turner, now known as Lieutenant Turner, thank you for your leadership here at Hood, and thank you for your continued commitment to our country and serving our nation. To the esteemed faculty, proud families, and graduates of Hood College, I am deeply honored to address you at this momentous occasion. And to the class of 2024, congratulations for a job very, very well done. To the parents and other family members of the graduates, thank you for the love and support that you have poured into these students. I know that the sacrifices you made and the encouragement you provided over the years helped make today possible. Today is also Preakness Day in Baltimore. So I will understand that if your mascot, Blaze, must leave early, I wish him good luck in the race, and I hope he's a mutter. Graduation marks a profound turning point in your life. It's not only the culmination of years of hard work and dedication, but it's also the beginning of a new chapter filled with opportunity. What will you do with that opportunity is up to you. Today, as you stand on the threshold of a new journey, I want you to think about the power you hold in the world. Yes, you have power as students, as graduates, as citizens. For many of you, this is your first in-person graduation ceremony because of the pandemic. But even if you walked the stage before, there's no student in America was immune from the unforeseen impacts of COVID-19 had on the educational system. The pandemic affected us all in different ways. It may have taken us a bit of time to get organized, but as a nation, we found a way to come together in an unprecedented manner to serve the unimaginable and help others do the same. When children were suddenly without critical school lunches, we worked together to make sure they didn't go hungry. When small businesses and restaurant workers were suddenly without patrons, we found a way to keep them open and on the job. And we found a way to hang on to the essential values of friendship, family, and service to our community. We also learned many valuable lessons, including this: the world can change on a dime. One day we were seeing friends and hugging our families, and the next day we were wiping down our groceries and learning about the trials and tribulations of Joe Exotic, Carolyn Baskin, and the Bee Tiger King. One second you were looking forward to walking across a high school stage, and the next you were trying to conceptualize a graduation that traded caps and gowns for virtual receptions and masks. The lesson here is, do not wait. Do not wait to show your family and friends how much you care. And do not wait to find your own path. When Hood College was first founded in 1893 as the Women's College of Frederick, women weren't allowed to vote, couldn't own property, and had limited opportunities to pursue higher education. Institutions where women could receive an education were scarce and often limited in their range of courses. But this institution knew the power of knowledge and how it could ever for change the course of history. While much has changed since its inception to this day, Hood College still holds these core values: hope, opportunity, obligation, and democracy. It prepares you to serve your communities and address the challenges of the future. Hood College prepares you to go out into the world and be leaders and serve your community, no matter your chosen path. This degree you are receiving today gives you that power. Your generation holds much power in the future of this country. At this moment, you face a critical inflection point, one that requires each of you to envision a future in which you want to live. The crises affecting our societies are unprecedented. Whether America will live up to its highest ideals, whether we will expand freedom and fundamental human rights to all people, and whether we will take action to confront the climate crisis will be for your generation. Every generation faces similar challenges, but also unique ones. In speeches throughout the ages, the phrase, "this generation of America has a rendezvous with destiny," is often cited. The phrase was first said by Franklin Roosevelt in his acceptance speech on the renomination of the presidency, and is commonly used by politicians whenever they face a particularly tough challenge or a defining moment. But this phrase goes beyond just politicians, because each of us have a hand in our future. By your actions, you help to advance on Hood's core value, hope. It could be your individual future, your family, your community, or your country. Each has a chance to rendezvous with destiny. And the best way to do this is to pursue public service, pursuing another of Hood's core values, obligation. Public service comes in many shapes and sizes. You do not have to pursue elected office to pursue a career in public service. Public service is about helping others. It means do not be a bystander. Get involved. Help and make a difference, however possible. Public service is less about what you lose and more about what you give in order to gain. If you become a teacher, go to an underserved community and teach kids so they may be inspired and equipped to follow in your footsteps. If you become a banker, provide financial services to underbanked communities that are at the mercy of predatory lenders. If you become a food industry executive, put an end to food deserts so families can have affordable, nutritious meals. If you become an entrepreneur, start a business that provides good-paying jobs for people that need economic security. As Hood graduates, you have the skills to help others, but you also understand the need for community support. No one can do it alone. It takes a village. Each of us has been supported by family, friends, classmates, and soulmates. Your skills taught here at Hood College underscore the need for collaborative action. I saw the need firsthand in March. At 4 a.m. on March the 26th, I was awakened by a call informing me of the catastrophic collision of the Dolly into the Francis Scott Key Bridge in Baltimore, causing its immediate collapse. Lives were lost. The shipping channel into the Port of Baltimore, the third busiest in our nation, was blocked by thousands of tons of steel and concrete, and a major East Coast traffic artery was severed. I saw firsthand the importance of individual leadership, but it was the community's engagement that provided the effective response. Although it was a state bridge, the federal government was there with their expertise and resources that were beyond the state's capacity. Private citizens, nonprofits, and businesses from the community were there for the victims of the tragedy and their families. First responders were fed by local restaurants that closed their business to the public to support the rescue, recovery, and debris removal. It took a community. The six victims were immigrants doing dangerous work to keep our highways safe, work that most of us would not do. Neighbors joined together in candlelight vigils for the victims. Their families were cared for by the community. The Small Business Administration set up centers to help small businesses that depended on the operation of the Port of Baltimore. The channel is now substantially opened, months earlier than thought possible, bringing thousands of workers back to work, thanks to the community. And the Francis Scott Key Bridge will be rebuilt, thanks to the community. Governments, nonprofits, businesses, engaged private citizens, working together, our community. With community support, you are ready to meet. You made it through the global pandemic and the economic fallout that ensued. You overcame challenges of virtual learning that upended traditional in-person experience. For each of you, your college journey has been shaped by unconventional and unprecedented experiences. But despite these challenges, you made it here today, whether in all, and you should be proud of yourselves. You understood what Lily Tomlin meant when she said, "The road to success is always under construction." There is a term, tikkun olam, which is commonly defined as repairing the world through acts of charity, kindness, and justice. The idea of helping those in need was instilled in me at a very young age. And this led me to want to pursue public service while in law school, because I knew then I needed to help our community I cared about. My first year in the Maryland General Assembly, I didn't think I held much power. Why would anyone listen to me? I was 23 and in law school. But that year, I went to a community meeting and the people I met with needed a ball field for the Little League. There was a high school that had a ball field, but they couldn't use it because there was no fence. So I picked up the phone and called the mayor of Baltimore. I didn't expect him to pick up, let alone the city to install a fence 2 weeks later. Each of us need to take advantage of another of Hood's core values, opportunity. While the Little League ball field may seem inconsequential to some, it was a starting point. It showed me that I had the power to make a difference. The ball field may start the career of the next Cal Ripken, or the beginning of a child's career that allows them to attend college, or even just a place for a child to go to find mentorship or friendship. Since then, I've worked to solve problems that some would classify as more consequential. I helped to pass the Affordable Care Act, so no American fears going to a hospital or doctor when sick, and the Inflation Reduction Act, the largest climate investment in reducing carbon pollution in U.S. history. I am proud of these achievements, but still we are seeing unprecedented attacks on civil rights and our democracy. The ERA is still not part of our Constitution, and women's rights are being stripped away every day. On January 6, 2021, I witnessed firsthand an insurrection at the U.S. Capitol, an attempt to prevent peaceful transfer of power, a hallmark of our democracy. Each of us have a responsibility to protect our democracy, another of Hood's core values. Our democracy is at a crossroads. Will it prevail or will it perish? Will we come together or will we stay divided? Popularized by Uncle Ben and Spider-Man, with great power comes great responsibility. Just like the generations before you, you must decide how you will use that power. Will you use your voice to advocate for solutions? Will you use your skills to be a service to your community and nation? Will you be a champion of democracy? My one wish is that you use your power wisely, locally or nationally or somewhere in between. Do not waste the opportunities before you. As you continue out into the world, I encourage you to remember the values that have shaped you here at Hood College: hope, opportunity, obligation, and democracy. As the motto of the college enjoins you to do, work with your hearts, minds, and hands. Serve your communities, extend a hand to your neighbors, and use your power for good. In 1915, the cleric and theologian John Wesley gave advice that is so relevant for this moment. He said, "Do all the good you can, by all the means you can, in all the ways you can, in all the places you can, at all the times you can, to all the people you can, as long as ever you can. Never stop fighting for what you believe in. I encourage you all to pursue public service no matter what that looks like. Remain steadfast in your resolve to tackle tough challenges. Take a moment and bask in your accomplishments. It's an exhilarating time. But then go out into the world, find your passion, and use your power for good. Congratulations again to the class of 2024.
Thank you, Senator Cardin, for those wonderful words and wise advice. And now we come to the part of the program that is our very reason for being here today. And look at that, again, the rain went away. It's almost like I planned that. I welcome April Bolton, Dean of the Graduate School, to present the doctoral degree candidates.
Thank you, President Chapdelaine. Candidates for the degrees of Doctor of Business Administration and Doctor of Organizational Leadership, please rise. President Chapdelaine, by authorization of the faculty and the Board of Trustees, I have the honor to present these students as candidates for doctoral degrees.
By virtue of the authority vested in the Board of Trustees of Hood College and by them delegated to me, I confer upon you this degree with all the rights, privileges, opportunities, and obligations pertaining thereto.
Candidates for graduate degrees, please come forward. Candidates for the degrees of Master of Arts, Master of Business Administration, Master of Fine Arts, and Master of Science, please rise. President Chapdelaine, by authorization of the faculty and the Board of Trustees, I have the honor to present these students as candidates for master's degrees.
By virtue of the authority vested in the Board of Trustees of Hood College and by them delegated to me, I confer upon you this degree with all the rights, privileges, opportunities, and obligations pertaining thereto.
Candidates for graduate degrees, please come forward. First, our Doctor of Business Administration graduates, Rodney Mosley, Rania Farouk Radwan. Rania's daughter, Amnea, is earning her master's degree today. Now, our Doctor of Organizational Leadership graduates, Dr. Darnell Eric Billups. Adam Cubbage. Stephanie Ryan Dinga. Cynthia Johnson. Essence Melise Jones. Adelaide Marius Niguela. Sandra Reese. Brad W. Young. Brad's brother, Brian N. Young, earned his master's degree in 1991. And now, our Master of Arts graduates, Laura M. Chatterson, Scott Michael Koblenz. Roberta Coover, Caitlin Craig, Jennifer Ballum Creeder, Emily Ryan Cronice. Emily's uncle, Paul Cronice, earned his master's in 1992. Loretta Mathis Greaves. Jessica Matthews Hopkins. Sue Ellen Hum. Megan Rose Marshall. Caleb Shank. Lindsay Olson Steele. Rosa M. Torres. Michelle L. Townsend. Sophie Wright. And now, our Master of Business Administration graduates, Alejandra Acosta. Emma Claire Barr. Vanessa Blagman. Daniel Brennan. Nick Klingen. Ann Catherine Coleman. Samuel Christian Driscoll. Alex Dujak. Brandon Feuerherd. Ellison Hannah II. Maura Heavy. Molly Rose Kushner. Tanner Leonard. Christopher Moza. Margaret Mosley. Amanda Oakes. Bimala Oja. Aline Romsberg. Aline's sister, Hannah C. Romsberg, is from the class of 2020. John Safran. Giovanni Saglimbeni. Billy Windley Seymour. Marilyn Dana Suarez. Michael Jeffrey Wallace. Yes. Kevin L. Wilfong. Our Master of Fine Arts graduates, Catalina Chiquillo, Kathy Grove, Emily Hampson, Sarah Spaith Riley. And finally, our Master of Science graduates, Khalid Abid. Adedonton Adetona. Flourish Adetoya. Flourish's brother, Abayomi Pelewura, earned his master's in 2019. Jennifer Ainsworth, Abdulaziz Nawar Al-Haddad, Bandar Nabil Al-Bukhari. Fahid Al-Dosari, Shada Al-Kabir, Malak Badr Al-Muteri, Muhammad Abdulrahman Al-Turki, Meghna Anumala, Carly Elizabeth Algenbaugh. Alice Bai. Paige Barrel. Jason Bear. Vasuki Balasupramanian. Christine McNeil Barrett. Caroline Elizabeth Benfer. Denise Berger. Denise's parents are both Hood alums. Mom, Dawn, is from the class of 2007, and Dad, Douglas, the class of 2003. Connor Bird, Cassandra Bohm. Nitya Boja. Caitlin Board. Caitlin's mother, Deborah E. Sullivan, earned her master's degree in 2008. Whitney Elizabeth Brucci. Christopher Robert Birch. Christopher Dylan Bergenson. Alicia Cassiopo. Indra Kiran Reddy Chandula. Priyanka Chikuri. Madan Chitamseti. Kennedy Collins. Jyoti Dontapalli. Amy Catherine Del Persio. Drew Demich. Drew's wife, Samantha Slick, earned her bachelor's degree in 2016 and her master's in 2020. Madhumita DeReddy. Christina Doe. Gerard Duncan. Scott Urey. Hillary Michelle Fisher. Scott. Wonderful. Gerard Duncan. Hillary Michelle Fisher. Heather Michelle Fisher. Delana Kai Ford. Dominique Forsman. I see, Heather. We're just a little out of order. Now, Heather Domeyer. Congratulations. Hillary Michelle Fisher. Delana Kai Ford. Dominique Forsman. Teresa Marie Fowler. Aravind Gadam. Aravind Gadam. Radish Gadam. Sai Shankar Gadam. Terry Lynn Janelle Gaddis. Vera Garupati. Lakshman Gita. Priya Gill. Alyssa Eileen Goodson. Moria Gotumukala. Shannon Avery Green. Maria Gabriella Guisa Enciso. Rushi Kiran Gurijala. Megan Haynes. Megan's husband, Joshua D. Haynes, is from the class of 2012. Irina Hall. Nadia Elias Hani. Tyler Hansen. Stephen Housechild. Michelle Hurima. Logan Hendershot. Madeline Henline. Desiree Hernandez. utej epikaila. Christian Isenogle. Nadim Salim Jamdar. Erica Scheibel Jennings. Blair Johnson. Rohid Jopali. Derek James Case. Munvita Kasu. Jessica Kaler. Victoria Cassiopeia King. Zachary Klug. Lexi Kun. Agnes Kuthai. Our mother-daughter duo, Agnes, is earning her degree today with her daughter, Princess Kuthai. Ian Lacey. Lauren Lanfer. Alyssa Joyce Leonard. Caitlin Grace Lowe. Jesse Lynch. Rachel Lyons. Fahima Majabin. Molly Mazel. Marissa Belia Maldonado. Sandeep Malipedi. Tulasi Morela. Zoe Par Maui. Jennifer L. Mayrovitz. Priyanka Ashley McGown. Caitlin McDearman. Zulema Medina. Emmanuel DaCosta Mensa. Matthew Robert Miles. Amanda Miller. Dustin Miller. Douglas Edward Milliken. Ashley Mitchell. Maria Mora. Krishna Priya Mula. Ashley Nail. Sai Rishita Namburi. Mutahar Nawaz. Bari Dakara Wilene. Woo! Ikene John Thomas Okorofor. Savannah Omatsea. Kwame Abeyi Opuni. Ernest Osai Yebowa. Ishita Panda. Ishita is earning her degree today with her twin sister. Ishpita Panda. Chandra Raja Chowdhury Pangaluri. Eric Manning Parker. Shiv Patel. Vasanti Pendela. Joe Poisel. Emmeline Annabelle Prince. Jasmine Proctor. Supash Pula. Lindsay Reed. Angela Ivy Rowland. Joanna Sabatino. Amnea Salem. Amnea's mother, Rania, earned her doctorate today. Harpreet Sarangul. Shiva Reddy Saredi. Rebecca Saxton. Tracy Schmeidel, Michael Schnabel, Stephanie Schulman, Monica Shanmugam, Mackenzie Shea. Kalina Simeonova. Lyric Rowan Sipe. Christopher Smalls. Lindsay Smith. Alana Sword. Jessica Sparacino. Alexis Janelle Speck. Meghna Shripati. Brett Strawn. William Alexander Strauss. Jose Anthony Mutu Susairaj. Carrie Ann Miller Swinehart. Kalyan Tulipali. Kalyan Tulipali, very eager to get that diploma. Prashant Totakuri. Swati Tiparti. Eric Tweeten. Sai Kumar Angala. Julian Urban. Lindsay P. Vance. Nicholas Vaughn. Hannah Vickery. Hannah's mom, Marianne Claggett Vickery, is from the class of 1980, and grandma, Rhea Robinson Claggett, from the class of 1936. Wow. Abigail Walk. Michael Ward. Karen Waffen. Marissa Wegford. Kristen Wingert. Derek Wild. Shur Shin Ming. Margaret Catherine Yeager. Priya Yera. Elizabeth Zabala. Edward Robert Zicchino and Emerly Zimmerman.
And now, Dr. Debbie Ricker, our Provost and Vice Presidents for Academic Affairs, will present the candidates for bachelor's degrees.
Will the candidates for degrees of Bachelor of Arts, Bachelor of Science, and the Bachelor of Science in Nursing please rise? President Chapdelaine, by the authorization of the faculty and the Board of Trustees, I have the honor to present these students as candidates for bachelor's degrees.
By virtue of the authority vested in the Board of Trustees of Hood College and by them delegated to me, I confer upon you this degree with all the rights, privileges, opportunities, and obligations pertaining thereto.
Will the candidates for bachelor's degrees please come forward?
Ready? Ready? Let's do this.
Carla Esther Aleman.
Woo!
Joseph Alexander. Jill Elizabeth Allen. Jill's mother, Lisa Pope Allen, is from the class of 1992, Aunt Angela Pope Kenna from the class of 1988, and Aunt Karen Pope Burdett from the class of 1990. Karen also earned her master's degree in 1997. Soren Almquist. Caroline Alvarez. Katie Amaguana. Caitlin Ambruster, summa cum laude. Remy Anderson, magna cum laude. Angela Anoki. Genevieve Jonisha Bubati. Evan Arthur Babalski. Parker Stewart Bear. Yvonne Marie Baker. Serena Balassi, cum laude. Axel Stephen Barahona Perez, summa cum laude. Avery A. Beal. Marceline Bellafiore. Jacob Bedeker, cum laude. Catherine Boston. Connor Gregory Bross. Madison Jane Brown. Logan Bruner, summa cum laude. Jen Bryant. AJ Batwinick, magna cum laude. Ashley Diana Cabrera. Dion Kane. Julia Lucille Cincetti. Lindsay Chapman, cum laude. Kevin Chow. Colby Benjamin Childs. Dustin Clark. Susanna Codd, magna cum laude. Alexis Cole, cum laude. Jasmine Lisette Cologne, magna cum laude. Elizabeth Connolly. Elizabeth Ann Cooper. Brittany Cooper. Okay. Skaden Cordery, magna cum laude. Jordan Renee Costley, cum laude. Gina Marie Del Monte. Mackenzie DeMeo, cum laude. Isabella DePaul, cum laude. Kalia Adiambo, Dea. Allie Dixon. Gabrielle Elizabeth Dolan, cum laude. Olga Marina Dunlap. Nicole Joy Dunn. Ian Emmanuel, magna cum laude. Nicole Etchison. Aaliyah Ferrand. Dylan Edward Fern. Christian Ficarra. Zoe Finholm, cum laude. William Fitch. Riley Larkin Fitz, summa cum laude. Emma J. Flanagan. Violeta Flores. Dewan Fonset. Victoria Foster. Jack Fricka, cum laude. Storm Fuller, magna cum laude. Colby Gallagher. Catherine Galletti, cum laude. Danielle Gardier. Madison Giroux, summa cum laude. Ashanti Gibbs. Aiden Gilsdorf. Brianna Gobel. Patrick Gogarty, cum laude. Madeline Goodling.
Goodings.
Madeline Gooding. Sky Hagverdi. Ariana Renee Hall, cum laude. Matthew Ryan Hardesty. Linnea Harvard. Evan Michael Hayek. Joshua Edward Hefner. Joshua's brother Tyler graduated in 2018. Allison Heyer. Aaron J. Heiner, summa cum laude. Shelby Ann Hendrickson. Lauren Abigail Herr. Noah Hirsch, summa cum laude. Jordan Michelle Herend. Cum laude. Jordan's mother, Sarah L. Garcia, is from the class of 2011, and grandmother, Michelle Boscheman Herney, from the class of 1978. Savannah Hingardner. Jenna Kylie Holtzinger, magna cum laude. Samuel Hull. Azana Iman Hutchison. Azana's mother, LaJuan Perry Jones, is from the class of 1994, and Aunt Lisa M. Perry from the class of 1997. Madeline Hutton, summa cum laude. Fatima Imtiaz. Fiona Catherine Janelle. Kaya Jenneret. Alex Jenkins. Catherine Joy Jenkins. Cum laude. Catherine's sister Elizabeth graduated in 2022. Kaylee Johnson. Kaylee's mom, Christine E. Johnson, graduated in 2016. Sienna Jones. Luke Owen Garber Jones, summa cum laude. Luke's mother, Rebecca L. Garber, earned her master's degree in 1998. Pankuri Kaptial, summa cum laude. Morgan Kamara. Bryce Keller. Ava Renee Kelly, summa cum laude. Emma Kelly. Emma's mother, Andrea B. Kelly, graduated in 2006. Alexandra Kelly, magna cum laude. Anna Kelly. Brianna Kidwell. Faith May Kaiser, summa cum laude. Sarah Jane Kluk. Key. Sarah's sister, Caitlin, graduated in 2022. Kaylin Cabasco. Morgan Crowell, summa cum laude. John Lee Wilson, magna cum laude. Brady Leonard. Brady's brother Tanner is from the class of 2022. Brianna LaPlatte. Alyssa Lowe, summa cum laude. Jordan Long. Jordan's sister Taylor is from the class of 2022. Marquise Lovett. Kathleen Lucas, cum laude. Jacob Schiller. Okay. Caitlin Elizabeth Lyons. William Machen. Catherine Maltby, cum laude. Tiffany Danielle Manning. Corey Elizabeth Mark. Corey's brother Stephen graduated in 2020. Kashif Masood. Elijah Matlock, magna cum laude. Elijah's father, Peter, graduated in 1998. Owen McDermott. Joey McDonough. Sullivan McGee, magna cum laude. Carly J. McQuay. Victoria Medor. Corvus Keys McKee. Catherine Hope Melendez. Shaylee Metzger. Shaylee's sister Ashley is from the class of 2016. Andrew C. Miller. Jordan Mushtabi. Joseph Monteleone. Tiffany Montez, Gabriel Murray, Faith Elizabeth Nail. Faith's brother Hunter is from the class of 2020. Christopher J. Nally, Marlise Anastasia Newson. Nathan Nogales.
Lydia Obang. Madeline Oliver. Madeline's mother, Diana Dahlgarn Oliver, graduated from Hood in 1986. Karina Elizabeth Oriana Jacome. Owen Policelli. Sammy Patnick. Robert Penny. Karina Alana Pericino. Max Peterson, cum laude. Catherine Phillips. Catherine's mother, Suzanne Lillard Phillips, graduated in 1987. Peyton Phillips. Olivia Piatanza. Alexandra Jeanette Pineda. Dakota Pitts. Dakota's sister Danielle earned her bachelor's degree in 2020 and master's degree in 2022. Gavin Pollard. Natalie Ann Poquiz. Markella Porter. Danae Pritchett. Catherine Paige Parisbaki. Nadia Rahman. Harrison Anton Rebstock. Michaela KK Redden. Tim Reinhardt. Christine Reese. Autumn Brooke Resnick, cum laude. Peyton Resiger. Logan Scott Rhodes. Rebecca Riedesel. Rebecca's father, John, earned his master's degree in 2002. Anthony Rispoli. Zion Rivera. Caroline Roberts, cum laude. Emilia Rowell. Emilia's sister, Sophia, graduated in 2017. Kayla Russell, magna cum laude. Ricardo Sandoval, cum laude. John Siwon Sanek. Jacob Saylor.
Jessica Schatz. Phoebe Schindler. Guinevere Skipper. Madeline Grace Schwab, cum laude. Tyler Schwartzman, summa cum laude. Kiana Petra Sylvia Scott. Rachel Amanda Sell, summa cum laude. Cheyenne Seymour, cum laude. Christina Marie Shanner, cum laude. Christina's sister, Angela Shanner Dwyer, earned her bachelor's degree in 2014 and master's in 2020. Her brother, Donald, is from the class of 2013. Atif Schott. Rachel Elizabeth Shaw. Samuel Joseph Shea. Rayana Schuster. Aiden Sievert. Kaylin Simmons. Luke Sisko. Haley Skelly. Megan Marie Slattery, magna cum laude. Adriana Smith. Amanda Brooke Smith, summa cum laude. Amanda's mother, Patricia St. Andre, is from the class of 1995. Haley Sofranco. Haley's mother is from the class of 1991. She also earned her MBA in 1999. Sarah Ann Sokolo. Stephen Summer. Emily Sponagle. Ashlyn Rose Stearns, cum laude. Trumaine Strickland. Janiel Surin Rodriguez. Kayla Renee Swain, summa cum laude. Sarah Grace Swanson. Sarah's mother, Cynthia Norwood Swanson Farmarco, is from the class of 1984. Aaliyah Brianna Tome. Sophia Townsend. Brandon Anthony Tran, magna cum laude. James Evan Tridepo. Valeria Trujillo. Noah Turner.
Oops. Wardrobe malfunction. Wardrobe malfunction. We're waiting.
Sam Turner, magna cum laude. Cody Upman. Mateo Valdezan. Brittany Modupe Vidal. Andrew Jacob Patrick Wareheim. Janaya Washington. Kayla Watkins Harvey. Cameron Andre Watson. Emily Webb, summa cum laude. Braden Wynell, magna cum laude. Braden's mother, Jennifer A. Wynell, graduated in 2011. Yoni Weldberg. Julie Wells, summa cum laude. Kara Wenner, magna cum laude. Kara's mom, Jennifer Holsinger Wenner, is from the class of 1998 and earned her master's degree in 2004. Deshaun White. Elizabeth Ann White. John Wyman.
I need a hug.
Rosie Williams. Victoria Williams. Eileen Witomski. Kaylee N. Wolf. Mackenzie Wright. Ryan Wright. Taylene Zekman. Awel Ahmed. Salman Al-Rashidi. Austin Counterman. Cum laude. Austin's brother, Sean Counterman, is from the class of 2017. Benjamin Davids. Summa cum laude. Sarah Friedel. Natalie Lee, summa cum laude. Natalie's grandfather, Daryl L. Visor, earned his MBA in 1996, and grandmother Robin L. Visor is from the class of 1996. Elijah Nathaniel Olson. Yeah. Anthony Rispoli. Subhashree Susindran, magna cum laude. Cody Jacob Wance. Carrie Wasilowski, magna cum laude. Carrie's mother, Karen M. Height, earned her master's degree in 1995. Mackenzie Marie Anders. Eos Asifa. Elizabeth Bahorik. Gabrielle Marie Benfield. Saul Bravo. Amy Melissa Castrojohn. Emily Frances Colangelo. Ayana Davis. Jenna Mae Donahue. Georgette Zubet. Abigail Feuerherd. Carla Gonzalez Ochoa. Karen Joanna Granados Sura. Luke Harned. Erica Marie Enriquez. Anna Hubbard. Abigail Jensen. Blessing Noel Johnson. Afua Quarantang. Ryan Lee. Barbara Valentina Martinez. Caitlin Tiso McTammany. Yakayla Mendez. Lauren Niebe. Amina Orland, cum laude. Jacob Orland.
Good job. Good job.
Megan Page. Diamond Richardson. Yeah. Natalie Sindlinger. Natalie Thrift, cum laude. Jocelyn Tower Mankow. Judith Velasquez. Kinsey Walker. Hannah Wilsbach, magna cum laude. And Tala Zing.
Congratulations.
All right. We are happy, excited, overjoyed to congratulate and recognize these students as now graduates of Hood College. Members of the class of 2024, please stand. And change your tassels. You can sit. I would now like to invite Jessica Keller, Faith Kaiser, Ashlyn Stearns, Julian Urban, and Kinsey Walker to the podium to lead everyone in the singing of the alma mater. Please rise if you are able.
Okay, class of 2024, let's get you out of here. Will you remain standing for this final brief blessing, an ancient one? Go forth into the world in peace, be of good courage, hold fast to that which is good. Render to no one evil for evil, but strengthen the faint-hearted, support the weak, help those who are afflicted, honor everyone. Work for justice and mercy, friends, and serve the holy as you know it. May love surround and uphold you, and may the vision of a real and lasting peace guide you always. Amen.
Well, it's not raining, so I can just keep talking, right? Just kidding. I would ask you to please remain at your seats until the platform party, faculty, and our graduates have recess. Students, you'll be able to find your faculty members by their department flags, and I'll be in the pergola for pictures. I now declare these commencement exercises closed. Congratulations.
Thank you.